Hi everyone, so in this video I'm gonna tell you some of my favorite cafes in no particular order, of course, that is in Bali. Here I'm just telling you some of the cafes that I went to, and it is in my top 10 list, I think, but in no particular order. By the way, if I did my nails, it's so cool. So here I have a list of the cafes that I'm going to tell you today. For the first one is Crabs and Coasters. It is located in the Kuta area. It's behind Beachwalk, and I think it's well known. I went there with my friend before quarantine, of course, before all this corona happened. I like the interior of the cafe. It is very cozy and cute, but I think it's a breakfast place more than a cafe. It is not that big. It's very, very Insta-worthy, and they have some good food there. And the next one is Dear Lucy. Dear Lucy is a cafe that is located in the Dewi Street area, even though it's not in the main street. The cafe itself has a very cute concept. The color palette of the cafe is very, very cute. It has a lot of mint and pink and blush and gold details. And what's special from that place is they have a dog. I don't know what's the breed of the dog, but it's such a cool concept. In certain times, the cafe give the customers to pet the dogs and take pictures with it. And the dogs are very, very friendly because they don't bark at all, and they're very well behaved. They don't jump at the customers, and it's very, very cute and fluffy. And the next one is Yogurt Republic. This one is a froyo place. They have a very unique concept because it's a self-service froyo place, and it has a lot of unique flavors in there and a wide range of toppings too. And they have sauces too, and you can dine in there or you can take away whichever you like. And by the way, I think there are several places of froyo place in Bali that is self-service, but I think Yogurt Republic is the best one because I don't know, their flavors is more well made than the others. I don't know, that's just my opinion. The next place is Titik Temu. Titik Temu is a cafe that is a joint business, I think, if I'm not wrong. It's with someone and featuring Raisa. Raisa is a singer in Indonesia. She has one, I think, if I'm not wrong, she has one in Bali and Jakarta. I think this cafe is has a very neat concept to it, and it has a lot of wood furniture and glass design of its building. I don't know, like, I'm not good at describing things, but I just love this cafe because it has a very neat concept to it, and their food is very, it's actually not that bad, but it's a very photogenic place. And the next one is Defolfer. I think this cafe is a very nice place for people who drink coffee because they offer a very wide range of coffee. Yeah. I don't know, there's something special about their coffee, okay? But I don't know what is it, because I'm not a coffee drinker, but I love this one because here's the thing, every time I go to Defolfer, it's very cozy, you know? And keep in mind, there's the smoking area and non-smoking area too. But personally, I think the smoking area is very, very cute. It's way more cuter than the non-smoking area, than the non-smoking area, because it's pink. And it has some beautiful paintings of Sakura, if I'm not wrong. And by the way, Defolfer also has like two places in Seminyak, Kayu Aya, if I'm not wrong. They have a baby one, baby Defolfer, and a big one, like the main one, in front of Seminyak Square. But it's not in the main road of Seminyak, Kayu Aya. You need to in this little street that they have, but it's worth searching for. It's not that hard to search. And for the baby Defolfer, I don't really recommend you going there because it's very, very small. Well, it's called baby, but here's my experience when I went there. I went there with two of my friends. We were very happy, I know, because we're catching up, okay? And there, in the Baby Defolfer shop, they only have two employees. I feel like they're rude a little bit bit rude, because when I went there, before we chat and sit down, they were very welcoming, like, hi, what do you guys need? Let us know. 5 minutes after we sat down, an employee approached us and said, oh my god, sorry, we're closing up in just like 10 minutes, so you better clean up, because we're about to close up. I mean, like, here's the thing, I don't know, it's like 3 in the afternoon. I don't know what's their closing schedule. Personally, I think it's very rude because we're taking pictures and chatting. I know it's like a very small space, but that's my experience though. The next one is Yamuna. Yamuna, I don't know where it's located. It's very hard to find, personally, I think. But it is very worth it to, if you go there. But keep in mind, I personally think never ever go there with a car, because it is very, very hard to find parking. So go there with a motorbike if that's possible. And it's very, very worth it because they have very, very amazing baked goods, especially their red velvet cake. It is very, very tasty and moist and flavorful, and the cream cheese is like very, very good. It's amazing. And I think from the ambiance of the place, it's very cozy. I think it's like a home cafe. Like, the back at the back of the cafe, the owner lived there, and just assuming that, it's very, very worth it to go there. Even though I think you might want to eat fast there, because it is a small cafe and it has a very limited sitting area. So you might want to think about the next customer that is waiting for them to be seated. The next one is Starbucks Reserve Dewata. I think that's the name. I don't know, it's like the Starbucks Reserve in Bali. And I just put this in the list because I think it's a very well-known place, I think. And all the tourists really want to go there. And here's my experience with Starbucks Reserve Dewata. I've only been there once, and also they actually have a restaurant. I forgot what's the restaurant called, but what I remember is the Starbucks area is in front of the restaurant, so the back area is the restaurant, and there's a middle area, like an open middle area, like a road. Here's the Starbucks. And you can go there with whatever vehicle, because they have a very, very big parking spot. And I love their design because it is very open. It has a lot of sitting area. And of course, it has a very, very good coffee smell. And it's just, the ambiance is very, very cozy. The next one is Pisón. I went to Pisón several times, and it is very, very nice there because all the employees are very nice, they're very welcoming, and they also have like a live music every Tuesday or Saturday night, I think, if I'm not wrong. And they have very amazing food. And it's very cozy, it has a good ambiance, and it's such a photogenic cafe. The employees, it's very nice. I just love it overall. And the last one is Skin Community. It's KYND Community. It's a vegan place, if I'm not wrong. I think it's a vegan place, but I don't think their food is really that amazing. But it has a good design to it. They have like a pink wall. It's very, very cute to take some pictures for Instagram or something like that. But personally, I think their food is not that great for my taste. And the last one, I promise you this is the last one. The last one is Cafe Organic. And I think their entrees is not that good because I tried my friend's. I forgot what did she order. She ordered like a salad. I don't really like it personally. Besides that, I think their desserts are very, very good, because even though it's vegan, but it's very good. I don't know why, it's very good. It has a clean design, interior design to it, and you can take some cute pictures like I did. And yeah, that's the last cafe that I'm gonna mention in today's video. That's all for the cafes, and let me know in the comment section below if you have any video suggestion that I should do, and I would happily do it for you. And don't forget to subscribe. Finally, I'm plugging myself. Don't forget to subscribe and check all my socials in the description box down below. See you guys on my next video. Bye.